This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. We thank God for this day. We thank God for this choir. Come on, help me celebrate God for them. Amen. Good to see all of you. And the words of Peter, it's good to be here. It's good to be in the house of the Lord. One more time, it's good to be here. Thank God for this January sermon series that we've been preaching, the year of victory. We're claiming this is our year of victory. And the first week we talked about victory over my life. Last week we talked about victory over my enemies. And I'm excited about what the Lord will have us here on today. Amen. Mark chapter 5, Mark chapter 5, I want to read the 25th verse through the 29th verse. Mark chapter 5, I want to dip a new bucket in an old well. Don't let your familiarity of the text rob you of the new revelation that God would have you here on today. We've heard this preached on many a times, and you've heard this story, but I believe God has a fresh word for it today. Amen. Mark chapter 5, verse 25, and it reads, "And a certain woman, which had an issue of blood 12 years, suffered many things of many physicians, and had spent all that she had, and was nothing better, but rather grew worse. When she had heard of Jesus, came in the press behind, and touched his garment. For she said, if I may touch but his clothes, I shall be made whole. And straightway the fountain of her blood was dried up. She felt in her body that she was healed of that plague." I want to talk about victory over my health. I want to talk about victory over my health. Victory over my health. Mark chapter 5 deals with three stories. Mark chapter 5 deals with the power of Jesus Christ over demons, death, and disease. Mark chapter 5 commences with a demon. The Lord is our psychologist. There's a man who's been living in the graveyard. He's been living among tombs. The Bible says that he's been trying to cut himself. The Bible says that this man, many friends and family members have done all they could do to help this man. They've been trying to bound him with fetters and chains. Nothing could hold this man. Jesus steps out of a ship. From afar off, this man sees Jesus. He has not recognized anybody. He cannot even look in the mirror and recognize himself. Because this man is what's called a legion. A legion is one that had thousands of demons living inside of one person. Everybody is pulling and tugging on him internally. Everybody is speaking and talking inside of him. But when he sees Jesus, the Bible says that he runs, falls at the feet of Jesus, and worships Jesus. He did not recognize anybody. Satan had this hold on them. But when he got to Jesus, he fell and bowed and worshiped him. Don't you know every knee has got to bow? If you're going to help me now, be a good time to start. Every tongue is going to confess. And he says, Jesus, what have I to do with thee? Are you here to torture me? Are you here to condemn me? But here's what Jesus did. Jesus spoke not to the man, but spoke to the demons inside the man. See, you got to know who to talk to. When we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against spiritual wickedness in high places. You've been arguing with people when you need to argue with the demon living inside of them. I ain't got no help in here. You're wasting time and energy talking to people that don't even know they're talking back to you. You got to start talking to the power that's inside of them. Jesus speaks to the man. But here's what I like about the Lord. The Lord told the demons to get out of this man. The demons left the man, went into some pigs, and the pigs went off the cliff, and they died. Can I say that again? They came out of the man, into the pig, off the cliff. Here's the shouting point, and here's where mercy lies. When God could have killed him, he just killed the stuff that was inside of him that was messed up. And thanks be to God that God gives all of us a second chance when God should have wrote all of us out. And that ought to be your prayer. God, take out of me anything that don't look like you. Take out anything that's got me separated from you. God, remove everything out of me that's not of you. Speaks to the demons. The Lord is a psychologist. It commences with the demon. The Lord is a psychologist. But Mark chapter 5 concludes with death. The Lord is a pediatrician. Oh, y'all gonna help me today. That there was a man by the name of Jairus. I feel like preaching today. Jairus was a synagogue ruler. He was one that had power, platform, and prestige. He was one that had clout in church. He was one that had status in church. But he had a daughter. This daughter was sick, and he knew this daughter was sick. And the text says that he went to Jesus and says, Jesus, my little girl lies at the point of death. He gets there, and when he gets to Jesus, he falls at his feet. That's the second person that has fallen at the feet of Jesus. I got to tell you, when you need something from God, you don't care who's looking. You don't care what your title is. You don't care what you got on. Oh, my God. You'll fall at the feet of Jesus to get his attention. See, that's why I don't like new school church. That's why I don't like the way people worship now. They're too sedated to worship now. They got new clothes on. They don't want to mess up nothing. But I remember growing up, have I got a witness? They didn't care what they had on. They didn't care who was looking. Ain't got no heaven. They go one way and wigs go the other way. Have I got any heaven here? They didn't care if they had runs in the stockings. They didn't care what they had on. They came to worship the Lord in spirit and in truth. And I wonder who is anybody who can testify. I ain't too bad and bougie to worship God. I'll do whatever it takes to worship him. You don't know like I know what he's done for me. You don't know what he's kept me from. You don't know what he's delivered me from. I've got a right, I've got a reason, and a responsibility. I ain't too bad and bougie to bless the name of the Lord. Oh God, I'll do whatever it takes. He falls at the feet of Jesus. He didn't care because he had status. He didn't care because he was a synagogue ruler. He had a need, and he fell at the feet of Jesus.
But let me tell you, he's at the feet of Jesus, but his life gets put on pause. This woman, who I'm going to tell you about in a minute, comes and interrupts Jesus. And he has to patiently wait until Jesus gets through with her. And when they're now finally on their way to the house, I got to tell you about that. Jesus makes house calls. I'm glad Jesus makes house calls. I don't care what you do. I don't care what you have. We got going on. I don't care how bad it is. The Lord makes house calls. Have you ever showed up to your house just in time? Jesus shows up to the house. And the text says that while he's on his way, the text says that the synagogue servant says, "Your daughter has died." Jesus goes to the house and he takes Peter, James, and John inside. Jesus goes to the house. He takes in Peter, John. Everybody with him always. Mountain of Transfiguration. He only took Jesus, James, and John. Let me pause and tell you, everybody can't go everywhere with you. There are some people that you just got to leave outside. Have I got a witness in here? Jesus goes in and he says, "Listen, why are you making this ado? Why are you carrying on like this? For this girl only is asleep." I'm glad that Jesus has the last word. Because what's dead to some people is only sleeping to Jesus. And I got to tell you, I don't care what report you get from who, you better go ask the Lord, "What do you say? I know the doctors gave me a diagnosis, but Lord, what do you say? I know the banks may refuse me, but Lord, what do you say? I know the supervisor said in the HR department said I didn't get the job, but Lord, what do you say?" God always has the last word. He touches that little girl, and that little girl raises from her sleep. It's with a demon. The Lord is... It concludes with, the Lord is a pediatrician. But it now centered with, is a physician. Here it is. I told you, Jairus has come to Jesus, fell at Jesus' feet, told him that my daughter lies at the point of death. She's sick. I need you. And so here it is. Jesus to go to Jairus' daughter. Girl, this woman comes uninvited and breaks up Jesus' detour, his tour. Bible says that, here's how Mark says it, verse 5, chapter 5, verse 25, he says, "And a certain woman," he says, she's really less than, she's not even important enough to have a name, she's just a certain woman, she's really not important enough to be mentioned, he says it's just a certain woman, he says she's had an issue of blood for 12 long years. I got to tell you, 12 years is a long time to have a condition. 12 long years is a long time to have the same issues over and over again. Can't you imagine? She has to wake up to this issue, go through her daily routine with this issue, lay down at night, face this same issue, and wake up in the morning and start this same thing over again. She comes to the point and says, "Lord, I've had enough." Yeah. Have you ever been there? You've been trying everything you could do. You tried many options. You tried many things. But you come to the conclusion that, "Lord, if I'm going to stay sane and if I'm not going to throw in the towel, you got to help me." Yeah. Certain woman, she has this issue of blood for 12 long years. Let me ask you, what's your issue? Yours may not be an issue of blood, but I got to tell you, all of us got an issue. All of us struggle with something. All of us got a problem. All of us got something that we're dealing with. Everybody has issues. Everybody has something that they're dealing with. This certain woman, she has an issue of blood for 12 years, but Mark helps us out by telling us that this woman shows us that if we do a few things, we can be healed. And I got to tell you, if there's ever a time that we've seen so much sickness, it's now. Everybody dealing with some kind of sickness. cancer and lupus and high blood pressure and everything, heart attacks and strokes. Sickness is running rapid. I mean, it seems like when you go to the doctor for one thing, they find out you got something else. They tell you, take this, but it may mess up five other things. I mean, it's always something. And you got to understand that your health is important. I got to tell you, churches don't like to talk about issues such as your health. But I got to tell you that health is important, because what can you do for God when you're not physically good? Everybody talks about spiritual awareness, but what about health and physical awareness? That's why you got to eat healthy. I know it's hard. I'm trying to get on that track myself. This I ain't wore this in a long time. It didn't fit this tight. I had a lot of more room in this last year, but it's a little tight now. Got to eat healthy. You got to take care of your body. Even if you're young, you got to watch what you let deposit in your body while you're a youth, because it can affect you down the road. You got to eat healthy. You got to exercise. Healthy living is what we don't talk about, but the church needs to. But here's what this woman says. She says, if we're going to have victory over our health, there's a few things that you and I must know. She says, number one, discover the one who can help. Nothing clever, just clear today. Discover the one who can help. Watch what it says in verse 26. And had suffered many things of many physicians. Spent all that she had. Was nothing better, but rather grew worse. Here it is. But when she heard of Jesus, I hear you, Holy Ghost, came in the press behind and touched his garment. She has suffered many things, many physicians. She's been to many hospitals. She's been to Vanderbilt. She's been to St. Thomas. She's been everywhere. She's been to William Medical Center. Nobody can help her. Nobody can heal her, and not only is it not better, but the text says she's gotten worse. Oh, the text says she spent all of her money trying to get better. I know a young man, very wealthy man. He went overseas, spent a lot of money. He had cancer, went overseas, spent thousands of dollars. And still got no better. Spent money on top of money trying to find physicians that can help. But nothing was better. Here's it. I need to tell you this. I don't care how much faith you have. The Lord has anointed doctors to help you. I got to tell you, because there are some people that say, I got faith, I don't need no medicine. I don't care how much faith you have. It's good to have faith. But God has anointed and given doctors wisdom and knowledge. Don't tell them take some ginger ale and go to sleep. You need to go to the doctor. I'm not bashing doctors and nurses. I believe nurses and doctors are gifts from God. And we need to utilize the gifts that God has given us. But in her case, she's tried these doctors. Nothing has gotten better. She's rather grown worse. But here it is, verse 27. When she heard of Jesus. I got to pause right there, because Bible says that faith cometh by. I'm trying to check y'all reflexes. And hearing by. I like it when you talk back to me. Faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Here it is. Somebody got the word out. Woo, that Jesus was in town. Oh, The church is packed now because they got the word out that Jesus was in town. And that's what we ought to do. We ought to get the word out that at Locust Ridge Primitive Baptist Church, y'all gonna help your boy, 4991 Murfreesboro Road, Arrington, Tennessee 37014. God is here. Oh, you got to get the word out. She heard that Jesus was in town. Perhaps she heard that Jesus healed he healed the man that was paralyzed. Perhaps she heard that Jesus healed the man that had satanic struggles. She heard that Jesus was in town. But here it is. No longer is she hearing that Jesus is in town. Jesus now has come and she can experience him for herself. I got to tell you, it's good for mama and daddy to know the Lord. It's good for grandmama and granddaddy to know the Lord. But you got to go to a point where you come from hearing God and knowing him for yourself. Oh, I love the testimonies of other people. I love hearing what God can do for everybody else. But when I was younger, I heard the testimony of the older saints. But when I got older, when I ran into my own problems, when I ran into my own bills, when I ran into my own haters, I found out that he's more than just what I heard. Now I know him for myself. Some of y'all ain't moved all service. Anybody glad you know him for yourself? Anybody glad that you heard, you moved from hearing to believing and knowing? Somebody know he's a healer. Somebody knows he's a way maker. Somebody knows he's a heart fixer. Somebody knows he's a mind regulator. I ain't supposed to be here. Do you know him? Have you tried him? Y'all stop. I got more sermon. I'm glad I know him. For myself. She heard that Jesus, Mary's baby. Whew, I'm trying to let this thing alone. The lily of the valley. Jesus, the bright and the morning star. Jesus, my coming in and my going out. Jesus, the Alpha and the Omega. Jesus, the beginning and the end. Jesus, the one that came down. Sit down, y'all making me nervous. You're making me nervous. She heard that this man. I missed my exit. I sure wanted to go there, but I got more sermon. She heard that this man is in town. She heard that here what she did. She came in the press. That word press means a crowd. She came through the crowd. She came through the crowd and touched his garment. Have you ever had to just press your way through some stuff? I mean, after all you were dealing with, perhaps you had to press your way to church today. Perhaps you didn't feel like getting out to bed today because all the hell you've been catching all week. Have you ever just had to press your way to church? Oh, have you ever had a Monday or a Tuesday experience where you said, Lord, if I can just make it to church. After all these low-down supervisors and friends are phoning, family them lost their last man. But if I can just make it to the house of God, I've got a feeling that everything is going to be all right. Don't you miss church. It's a dangerous thing to miss church. Because you don't know when God is going to show up with your miracle from what you've been praying for. You don't know when God is going to give you your deliverance in the house of the Lord. You got to discover the one who can help you. Here's what Jesus says. Woman, you've been trying everybody else. Now give me a try. It's like that slogan, you've tried the rest, now go on, catch the best. I ain't got no help in here. You tried everybody else, and that's our problem. We go to everybody else when either two things. Number one, they can't help us, or they got their own problems that they can't even fix themselves. Jesus, he says that you can come to me. She discovered the one who can help her. But watch number two. Here's what I really want to talk about. You got to declare your own healing. Yeah. Woo. You got to discover the one that can help. But you got to declare your own healing. Watch what it says in verse 26. Verse 26 says, verse 28, here it is. For she said, if I may touch but his clothes, I shall be whole. And straightway the fountain of her blood was dried up, and she felt in her body that she was healed of the plague. She said, if I may touch but his clothes. She said, I've tried everybody else. I've given everybody else my time. I've tried everybody else. I've tried other solutions. She says, but let me try this man by the name of Jesus. She goes to Jesus. Can't get to him because it's a large gathering of people around him. Everybody is thronging Jesus, which meaning they're pulling and pushing and tugging on Jesus. I got to say this. Everybody around Jesus is not with him for who he is. Some people are only around him for what he can do. Don't look at me like that. Some of y'all know some folk like that. They're not around you for who you are. They're only around you for what you can do for them. And here's what the Lord needs. The Lord doesn't need any more fans. He needs followers. Preach, Mason. The Lord doesn't need fans because fans are fickle. When you do something they don't like, they leave you. But when you got followers, I'm sticking with you, Jesus, in my good days. I'm sticking with you in my bad days. And you got to move from being a fan to being a follower. He doesn't need no more fans. Fans say, I'm with you when I got money in the bank. But followers say, Lord, even when I'm broke, I'm going to give my 10 cents and I'm still going to go to church. Fans are with the Lord when everything in your family is going good. But followers say, Lord, even at the gravesite of a loved one, I'll still bless your name. Fans are fickle. But when you got followers, you in it for the long haul. And that's what God wants to know. What are you? Are you a fan? Or are you a follower? He says he needs more followers. Oh, he says, you got to declare your own healing. Listen, she ain't talking to nobody but herself. I know folks say you shouldn't talk to yourself. Oh, but there's been many days. Don't y'all look at me like that. You ain't never talked to yourself. Here it is. When David was in Ziklag, I feel the Holy Ghost. When David was in Ziklag and he told the men, let's go to battle. They went to battle, and when David and his boys got back, everything was on fire. And their children and the wives were taken captive by the enemy. And they were getting ready to kill David. But you know what David said? David said, let me encourage myself in the Lord. Sometimes you got to talk to your own self. Sometimes you got to pat your own self on the back. Sometimes you got to tell yourself, if don't nobody else believe in me, I believe in me. You got to declare your own healing. She said, if I may touch but his clothes, I shall be made whole. Proverbs 18 and 21 says that death and life are in the power of the tongue. Some people don't know the authority that you have on your own life. Woo! Some people don't know the authority that you have on your own life. Some people don't realize the power that God has given you to speak over your own self. God has given all of us the anointing and the power to speak those things that are not. Romans, come here, as though they were. And I wonder, is it anybody that can testify, preacher, I've been there. When you spoke life over your own situation. The preacher couldn't get there quick enough. The deacon couldn't get there quick enough. The mother couldn't get there quick enough. You didn't have time to make it to Sunday morning, but you got your own oil out. Here. You laid hands on your own self and you said, self, you shall be healed. Woo. Sometimes we forget that we ain't gotta go to the priest for healing. No, you ain't got to go to the priest or the preacher or those in leadership. You have the authority to speak over yourself. You got more power than you know you got. You got to learn how to speak, and I dare you to just start speaking life over your situation. I dare you to go through your home and speak and plead the blood of Jesus. I dare you to go from cubicle to cubicle in that job where you don't nobody like you, but you just plead to let them think you're crazy. That way they won't mess with you no more. I ain't got no help in here. Let them think you done lost your mind. Start talking to yourself. I bet they leave you alone. How you doing, self? Self, I'm blessed and highly favored. How's the job going? I'm expecting a promotion any day now. Start speaking over yourself. I'm the head and not the tail. I'm above and not beneath. Here it is. I'm the lender and not the borrower. You got authority to speak over your own self. Woo. Plead the blood of Jesus over your family. When they leave your house to go to school with all these robbers and bombings and shootings in schools and in churches, you ought to cover your family in prayer. Oh, I'm done. You got to discover the one who can help you. You got to declare your own healing. Here it is. Watch number three. And I promise I'm in my seat. You got to demonstrate that you believe in him. Watch what he says in verse 30. And Jesus, after she had touched him, you know, she touched him and the blood was dried up. And she felt in the body, she would hear it on the plate. Here it is. And Jesus, verse 30, immediately knowing in himself that virtue had gone out of him, turned him about in the press and said, who touched me? Disciples said unto him, thou seest the multitude thronging thee, and you ask who touched him? He looked around about to see who had done this thing, but a woman, fearing and trembling, knowing that what she had done, came and fell down before him and told him all the truth. And he said unto her, daughter, here it is, thy faith hath made thee whole. Go in peace and be whole of the plague. She touches the hem of Jesus. She doesn't touch him. She touches his hem. She doesn't touch him. She touches his hem. And as soon as she touched Jesus, the Bible says, and immediately. Let the church shout, immediately. The old preacher will put it like this. He can speak and it's done. He can command. And it stands for, I thought I had some old school saints in the house. He said, and immediately he realized that healing and virtue had gone out of him. He asked, who touched me. I say it all the time. I think I ought to say it again here. That Jesus asked a question. Whenever Jesus asked a question, it was never for his own benefit. It was always for the benefit of the one whom he was asking. Jesus was not trying to get information that he did not previously know. Because why? Because we know Jesus knows all. He sees all and he hears all. Jesus asked, who touched me? Whenever Jesus asked a question, it was never for his own benefit. It was always for the benefit of the one whom he was asking. He asked Adam, where are you? He asked the man at the pool of Bethesda, will you be made whole? He asked Saul, why do you persecute me? Whenever he asked a question, it's never for him. It was for the one whom he was asking. And Jesus asked the woman, do you really know what you've done? Because according to the Levitical law, come on, Bible scholars, because of her condition of her bleeding, it made her unclean. And she was not to be mixing in the crowd. She was not supposed to be mingling and mixing with the masses. But she heard of Jesus. She pressed her way. And I got to tell you, sometimes you got to break some religion to get a relationship with him. Everybody got good religion, but not everybody got a relationship with him. She broke the traditional barriers and she got blessed. Many churches would be blessed if they tear down some traditional walls. We ain't never did it like that. That's the last words of a dying church. We ain't never did it like that before. I hear folks saying all the time, I don't say nothing. Locust Ridge ain't what it used to be. Oh. I want to go back to the old church. But here it is. Behold, I make all things new. The Bible says, here it is, no, the song says, and we sang it all the time, to serve this present age. It worked good then, and we thank God for our forefathers. We thank God for the Moses, but now it's a Joshua generation. And if you don't make ways for the Joshua, you'll be like Moses. You'll be dead and buried. Let me clean out my office. She broke the tradition to be blessed. She says, I don't care what protocol is. She says, this is a life and death situation. And she says, I gotta be blessed. She was determined that she wasn't gonna live the rest of her days like this. But here's what I like about it. She, here it is, fell down at his feet. The satanic man fell down at his feet. The synagogue ruler fell down at his feet. This sick sister fell down at his feet. I got to tell you that it does not matter what life takes you. You can determine what you do when you get there. Fall down at the feet of Jesus. Recognize, reverence, and worship him in spite of it all. I'm done, but Jesus says, daughter, your faith has made you whole. He says, I know ain't nobody else claiming you, but I'll claim you. He says, everybody else has written you off, but I'll still call you daughter. He said, don't nobody else want to be bothered with you, but I'll call you daughter. I'm glad when don't nobody else want to fool with Brandon. I ain't got no heaven here. The Lord still a talk to me. When don't nobody else text my phone or call me, the Lord will still talk to me. He says, daughter, your faith has made you whole. You got to have faith if you want to be healed. You can't be healed if you ain't got no faith. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for. It's the evidence of things that are not seen. I haven't seen the healing yet, but Lord, I believe it's on the way. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. We walk by faith, not by sight. Faith without works is dead. Come here, Jeremiah. Jeremiah said that he's a balm in Gilead. The children and Moses said that he is Jehovah Rapha. That means that God is our healer. I want to know, is there anybody here that can testify, I know he's a healer. This ain't for everybody. This is just for the people that you've experienced some sick days. You've confused the doctors. They said because of your health issues, you ain't even supposed to be here now. But I got to tell you that we serve a God who is a healer. And I've come on divine assignment today to speak prophetically in your life. That it doesn't matter if you got cancer in your body. We serve a healer. It doesn't matter if you have high blood pressure. We serve a healer. It doesn't matter if you got lupus. We serve a God who is a healer. Let me tell you, the Lord that we serve, he can even heal you without the assistance of medicine. He to touch me. I hear you, Michael. Lord, keep me day by day. Lord, keep my body strong. Is that your testimony today? Lord, I want you to keep my body strong so I can do the will of God. Is there anybody here that can testify you want the Lord to give you your health back so you can serve him the rest of your days? John recorded Son of God.
until you get the job. You ain't gotta wait until you get your healing. You ain't gotta wait until you get the promotion. You ain't gotta wait until you get the car. You ain't gotta wait until you get the house. Shop! Shop!
Somebody else that needs a healing, come unto me, all ye that are heavy laden. Take my yoke upon you and learn, for my yoke is easy and my burdens are light. Atmosphere. The Bible says where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty. And I feel healing in the room. I feel the power of the Lord in the room. If you're blessing, Lord, if you're blessing, blessing, please don't do it. Whatever, Lord, whatever you're doing. Every head bowed, every eye closed. God, we thank you for this day. God, we thank you for this moment. God, we thank you for victory over our health. In the name of Jesus. God, maybe somebody today is praying on behalf of somebody else. God, we ask that you would work it out for them. Even if they're not here, God, you can meet them where they are. We plead the blood of Jesus over our homes, over our families, over our children, over our finances. Everything we touch has to be victorious. God, maybe someone had a bad doctor's report, but God, your word says all sickness is not unto death. God, we thank you for your healing power that's resting on this house right now. God, we thank you for the Holy Spirit that's abiding with us right now. And God, when we leave this place, we'll echo the words that we've met your power. And we met your presence. And that we shall be revived when we shall leave this place. And God, we seal this prayer with the praise. And we thank you in advance. God, keep our body strong so that we can do your will. God, keep our bodies and keep our minds strong so that we can continue to do the work of Christ. We thank you. We give you glory. It's in Jesus' name. Amen. Hug somebody and tell them, be made whole. Tell them, be made whole. Tell them, be made whole. Be made whole. Be made whole. Be made whole. Made whole, be made whole. Yeah. Don't do it. Lord, whatever have I done? I hope this series is blessing you like it's blessing me. Listen, God has been working with my spirit and just giving me messages clear as ever just what to talk about. And I don't know who that was for today, but I pray it blessed you. I pray it blessed you tremendously. Victory over our life, our enemies, our health. And I'm excited about what the Lord will have us here on these next couple of weeks. And I'll give y'all a peek. I'm so excited about February series, and it ain't even close to February yet. The Lord been dealing with me with series. He's wrote my series almost for the whole year 2017. Just that clear. I've been listening. When you get in a place where you can just you and God, he'll talk to you. And we're dealing with just face it and taking off the mask. Because see, folk coming, and in front of you, they can be smiling, but you don't know what they're going through when they leave this place. They used to call it faking the funk. It's in February, so listen, you want to be here, amen. You want to be here, all right. And all of our visitors, we thank God for you. I guess I got to let y'all go. But whenever it's the spirit like this, I never want to leave just resting in the presence of God. There's a sweet Holy Spirit, yes, sir, in this place. And I know it's the Spirit of the Lord. I'm going to ask if our choir would minister. Yeah, come on. Thank you, Pastor. Thank you. Come on. Come on. Yeah. Come on. As we stand all over the building, maybe there's one that you want to come. Give your life. I told y'all I'm all the way over here somewhere. We're going to ask. Why don't you come? It's a good day. It's a good day to come and give your life to Christ. Come on. This is your day, your opportunity.
Come on.
bless you, God. Keep you, God. I give you strength. Here's our prayer. Come on, stand all over the building. We're going home. Good. We're going home.